All students, after collecting the certificates, please proceed to the conference hall for a short 5-minute discussion with the Vice Chancellor.
Thank you. founder, chairman, Colonel Professor Vel Sri Dr. Rangarajan sir, founder, president, vice chairman, Dr. Mrs. Sagundala Rangarajan ma'am, chairperson and managing trustee, Dr. Mrs. Rangarajan Mahalakshmi Kishore, vice president, Mr. KVD Kishore Kumar, honorable chief guest, Professor Dr. M.K. Surappa, vice chancellor, Anna University, faculty members, graduates, friends, and parents of burgeoning engineers, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, my salutation to one and all gathered here. It gives me a great pleasure to extend a cheerful, gracious welcome to our esteemed chief guest, Professor Dr. M.K. Surappa, Vice Chancellor, Anna University, Chennai, to the 14th graduation ceremony on behalf of Veltech Multitech, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Sagundala Engineering College. Indeed, it is a pleasure to stand before you to welcome the gathering on this achievement day. At this juncture, I take this pleasure wholeheartedly to congratulate each and every one of you on this remarkable achievement of graduation. My dear graduates, may your years ahead continue to be characterized by empathy, compassion, objectivity, and a willingness to take risk. May you always lead by example, work hard, and play straight. May your success be many and your tribulations are few and far between. I wish you everything that you so richly deserve in the years ahead. It has been an honor and a privilege watching your progress and success. I wish you all to be the great inspiration to the whole world throughout your hard work and smart work as well. My best wishes to each one of you. We are very proud of your accomplishment and outstanding performance during your 4 years of studies. Every graduate here today has worked very hard to make the best of themselves. You have persevered and worked towards your goals in a determined way. Especially in placement, where almost 80% placement was achieved on an average. The credit of such a successful employment is due to the encouragement and involvement of our ever-supporting management. We have now made you all ready to tackle the next set of challenges which will ensure you grow further. You all are a valuable asset to our Veltech Multitech. I hope everyone will contribute their knowledge and support for the well-being of the society, and once again, wish you all a great success for your bright future endeavors. Finally, let me also at this great moment thank all the parents for your active participation, and we have valued your input at all the times. It is only the joint support and association of all our stakeholders, including you, the parents, the students, and today turned us, our alumni, have made this institution, Veltech Multitech, at a higher level with its outstanding accolades, achievements, and with grateful highlights. The Department of Biomedical, EEE, IT, CSE, ECE, and Mechanical are NBA accredited one. NAC accredited with A grade for the first cycle, number one amongst Anna University affiliated colleges in Tamil Nadu with an impressive score of 3.49. NIRF India ranking in the consecutively 2 years, 2018 and 2017, in the band of 150 to 200. Anna University ranking 2017, Multitech stands 19th among 497 colleges. Veltech Multitech was awarded with the first place by the AICTECII as the best industry institute, linked institute in the nation in the year 2014 and the year 2015, thereby winning the title twice in a row for the outstanding performance in catering to the needs of the industry. Permanent affiliation for our CSE, ECE, EEE, IT, Mechanical, ME CSE, and Biomedical. Recognized research centers, ECE, EEE Physics and Chemistry. 123 lakhs research fund, 200 plus patents filed, 900 Scopus publication and 1000 publication in a peer review index journal. Average 80% placement record for 3 years. UGC 2F and 12B status. CSIRO recognized institution. DST FIS sponsored one. Entrepreneurship Development Institute approved by CED of Anna University. I once again congratulate my pioneers, those who are qualified to attend today's graduation.
Many of Veltech, Multitech, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Sakuntala Engineering College has been called on to confer the degrees in the branches of BE Biomedical Engineering, BE Civil Engineering, BE Computer Science and Engineering, BE Electronic and Communication Engineering, BE Electrical and Electronic Engineering, BE Mechanical Engineering, BTech Information Technology, ME Computer Science and Engineering, ME Embedded Systems Technology, ME Networks Engineering, ME VLSI Design and MTech Information Technology upon candidate who, in the examination conducted by Anna University, Chennai in 2017, held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same. Now I declare the graduation ceremony open. To honor the chief guest. Rangarajan Mahalakshmi Kishore to introduce the chief guest to the audience.
Professor Dr. M. K. Surappa, Vice Chancellor, Anna University. Professor M. K. Surappa, born on 5th December 1951 in an agricultural family in Mirali in Mysore district. He completed his school education in Mirali in Kannada Medium Government School. He obtained BSc degree in 1970 from Yuvaraja College of Mysore University. He joined the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore in 1970 and received BE degree in Metallurgy in 1973, MS and PhD degree from the Faculty of Engineering in 1976 and 1980. Professor M. K. Surappa joined the then newly established Regional Laboratory Trivandrum in 1979 as a senior scientist and worked there for 2 years. During 1981 to 1987, he was the research associate and engineer at Drexel University, USA, Cavendish Laboratory, University of Cambridge, UK, and Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, Switzerland. He returned to the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, as an assistant professor in 1987 and rose to the position of professor in 1998. He was the honorary secretary of Karnataka State Council for Science and Technology during 2004 to 2009. He was the visiting professor to Sri M. Vishweshwaraya Chair, University of Mysore, 2003-04. He has served as the founder director of Indian Institute of Technology, Ropar, for a period of 6 years, 2009 to 2015. He served as the Dean, Faculty of Engineering at the Indian Institute of Science during the year 2016-17. He assumed the post of the Vice Chancellor of Anna University on 12th April 2018. He is also the Honorary Professor at the Indian Institute of Science. Professor M. K. Surappa has made outstanding R&D contributions to the science and technology of metal matrix composites. For over 3 decades, he has pursued many innovative investigations on synthesis, processing, microstructure property correlation, and application development of MMCs based on light alloy metrics. These include development of stir cast process for the fabrication of aluminium matrix composites, process developed by Professor Surappa at the Indian Institute of Science, is often hailed as an Indian innovation by MMC producers across the world. Development of innovative technique for synthesis of metal ceramic nanocomposites by in situ pyrolysis of polymer precursors in the liquid melts. He has carried out all his research work entirely in India. Professor M.K. Surappa has published 100 research papers in international journals and presented nearly 150 papers in national and international conferences and has authored books. He has secured 1 U.S. and 3 Indian patents. Professor M.K. Surappa nurtured IIT Roorkee as an institute of excellence in research and governance. In the 2016 National Ranking of Institutions, IIT Roorkee stands among 9th among top engineering institutions. It is very heartening to note that IIT Roorkee ranked number 1 in 2 parameters used in ranking exercise, namely teaching, learning and resource and graduation outcome among 16 IITs. This is a testimony to the inspiring, dynamic and visionary leadership of Professor Surappa. Professor was bestowed with Sri M. Vishweshwaraya Award for his lifetime contribution in science and technology from the Government of Karnataka for the year 2015. Professor M.K. Surappa is a fellow of Indian National Science Academy, INSA, and Indian National Academy of Engineering, INAE. In the year 2015, Karnataka State Open University honored him by awarding him honorary degree of Doctorate of Literature. He received Suvarna Karnataka Rajyotsava Award by the Government of Karnataka in 2016 and Professor Rustam Choksi Award for Excellence in Research and Engineering from the Indian Institute of Science in 2007. He received Amulya Award for Innovation in 2012 by the Government of Karnataka. He has been bestowed with Metallurgist of the Year Award for the year 1998 by the Government of India. He is the recipient of MRSC Medal for the year 1997 from the Materials Research Society of India. Sir, I humbly welcome you to our campus. Wholeheartedly, and on behalf of Tamil Nadu, I feel Anna University is honored to have you as our Vice Chancellor. Thank you so much, sir.
I invite the Chief Guest, Distinguished Professor M.K. Surappa, Vice Chancellor of Anna University, Chennai, to deliver the graduation day address.
Welcome and good morning to all of you. Professor R. Rangarajan, founder president of the Veltech Multitech Institute. Dr. Shakuntala Rangarajan, founder's president and the vice chairman. Dr. Mrs. Mahalakshmi Kishore, the chairman of the group of institutions, Veltech institutions. Mr. Kishore Kumar, vice president. Dr. V. Rajamani, the principal of the college, members of the management, deans, heads of the department, faculty, and the staff of Veltech, Hi-Tech, Multitech, and the graduates of the 2017 batch, their very proud parents, family members, invitees, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'm very pleased to be here this morning. We have to address all of you on the occasion of the 14th graduation day. I thank the chairman, vice chairman, and all the management and the principal for inviting me to be here this morning. All of us know that today is a day of a very great fulfillment and a day of great joy to all of you, all the graduates, and equally to the very happy parents and the faculty members. My very warm wishes and congratulations to all the graduates, prize and the medal winners. On a graduation day, when the all of you are collecting your degree certificates and beginning your new life, I have a few things to talk about. It is basically based on the my own reflections, and perhaps you also will be thinking at some stage in the last few months after collecting the degree certificates what you will be doing and what kind of a professional challenges that you will be facing and how you can contribute to the society based on your degrees and how you move the technology, contribute to the people, both in the arena of technology that you have learned in the last 2 years, as well as a human being, how you can contribute to the people around you, especially in what you call in empowering them, creating awareness, and helping them, all the things that you have learned in the last 4 years. Of course, I also want to tell you how we can shape your own life and lives of the people around you, and the way you can contribute, the ways in which you can contribute in transforming the nation, that India, from developing to the developed nation, and thereby how we can shape the future of our society and provide a sustainable life for our future generations in the years ahead. I also want to tell you one thing. Your formal learning, classroom learning, in the last 4 years, although it some way perhaps formally it ends, but your learning process will not end. The learning of the life, learning of your all things that you have learned, what you have learned, how to utilize this one, it now begins now. And in order to keep abreast of all the things that are happening and to hone up your own skills, you have learned some skills and still many more things to be learned. And including your analytical skills, one is you have learned from the textbooks, all the laws of the fundamentals of engineering, how to apply, but you need to hone up your analytical skills now. Start asking questions, how, why, how it should be done better. So these are the questions that we should come to our mind. And you must be also be aware of the changes that are happening around you, especially in the last 10, 15 years, the technological changes, the life changes in life, the way you work, where you think, where you learn, where you entertain, and where you conduct the business, acquire services, and do all the things that you do has changed very rapidly, and is going to change much more. But if you look at this one, all these disruptive technologies that you have been seeing, it is not the end of it. The pace at which changes are happening, it will happen at much more faster pace. So if you have to be, you have to understand and make your contribution and to stand up, contribute to the society, you need to keep abreast all these changes, must be aware of the changes that are taking place and the changes that are likely to take place in the next 5 years and 10 years based on the learning, that you must keep aware of that one, you must be knowing all these things. And all these changes that are continually happening, you have adopted some changes, embraced some changes, but you must be ready to embrace the new changes that takes place in the years to come. And adopt those changes. And what you have learned is only a fraction, only a thing that will give you the foundations for you for to build your capacity further, more and more, especially your engineering capacity, capacity to think and adapt and apply to the various social problems and in your professional problem, in your own job. So you need to this one, especially the was mentioned to you, the kind of technological innovations that are happening, and that you must be keep aware of that one and adopt those innovations in your profession. And this is possible for you to keep abreast of these things, keep alive, keep contemporarily aware of all the things through the various, especially you are able to do this one through all the available technologies that already exist to you, especially the ICT technologies that you have, all the internet, web and all these things. You need to use this one and learn these various changes that are happening, especially all the breakthrough innovations that are happening, and you can learn this one, keep this one through what you call, through Google, and you can also use this internet, which can facilitate you learn much more things, more in detail the technological developments, newer principles, newer innovations, and this is possible through the various courses, book courses, online courses, web-based courses. I think you must spend a part of your time using these technologies that are already available, ICT technologies, so that you are always on the foot, on your toes, able to, you are not lag behind in connecting what you have learned and what is going to, what you are going to happen and elsewhere in the world, and with that, based on your previous understanding, you must be able to observe and embrace and apply in your professional life, otherwise the people around you and the society around you. So this is a very important appeal to you. This is a very fast-running, moving society, fast-moving technologies, and you cannot afford to be keep silent and waste what you call complacency, and you cannot live in a comfort zone thinking that you have learned everything. That is not the way. I think if you have to play an effective role, you need to learn these things through the various MOOC courses. I also know now you graduates have earned learned all the things, and some of you have already placed in various job positions, and some of you may not have got the positions, and you don't have to get disheartened about it. I know this is now the reason why perhaps some of you may not have secured jobs. Your skills may not be adequate, but you don't need to be apprehensive, get frustrated. Life is a very long child. You know, it has many challenges. What you don't get in 3 months, what you perhaps don't achieve in 3 months, that is not the end of the life. You have plenty of time. You have to learn from your mistakes, learn, you recognize what you don't know, and pick up those things, and that is possible to pick up those skills which are required for your employers through the various skill initiatives, and that's which is are available in these days in plenty by both the government of India as well as the government of Tamil Nadu. So you should not be hesitant to pick up those skills wherever it's available, and get ready for all the employers' requirements. In addition to that, you need to do this, what you call, placements are providing jobs to all of you is becoming more and more difficult for governments, for the corporations, and you must take a place there. You must move into that space, and you must become an employer. How do you become? You become a star, you know, you start up, you have your own startup based on very, very many technological things that you have learned, and some of the very great ideas that you have got in your mind, which you have developed, which you have nurtured in the form of exhibitions, projects during your last 4 years, and you must take a bold step, see how it can be further groomed, further nurtured, taken to a higher level, and that you must do as a part of a startup culture, where you not only create a wealth, create services, and also create an employment for your own fellow engineers. So you must not be hesitant. You must be enthusiastic, especially if everything is convenient to you. Many of you are much more affluent, very affluent compared to the people of my generation. You can afford to take that risk and have the startup for which lots of facilities are available by the government of India, through various ministries, government of Tamil Nadu, and you must think very seriously to contribute to this one, not only working, but having a startups and all. Then you must entrepreneur development. That is another thing, that you become an entrepreneur. And while coming from my place to this university, I learned this college. I must compliment what this college has been doing in the last several years. You know, earlier, the concept was many of this great accomplishment and in fact great learning can be done by only the government institutions. It is restricted to the elite institution like IITs and ISAR. It is no longer true. Every institution, your own institution has shown private institution what it can do. In fact, it can done so many of the things what many of the government institutions have been able to do. So if there is a will, if there is an enthusiasm, passion, support from the management, and you can be able to do all these things where, you know, you can also play your role. Your role as an engineer, as a technocrat, as an innovator, you can also play a significant role. It is no longer a monopoly or no longer confined to the engineers, to the graduates of the elite institutions like IIT and ISR. It is now, time has come. All the private institutions, which has been started by a great philanthropic mind and nurtured over the years, I'm very pleased to see this institution, and I've been seeing this one in the last 6 weeks, 8 weeks, going around the various institutions. Now the time has come for the private institutions to play a much bigger role in not only in the technological dissemination, innovations, and providing startups, entrepreneurship. I think this will go in a very long way, I am sure, because you know the way in which I think, because I come from the centrally funded institutions like IIT and IISc for all my life. This first time I'm here in the state institutions. I'm watching these private institutions playing a great role. I'm very much impressed with this one. I'm sure, I know you should take advantage of this one seize these opportunities and play your role in all this arena. You know, in innovation, in technology, in providing a service, entrepreneurship. So this time has come. Now, as an engineering profession, which you have learned in a various discipline, okay, in mechanical and all, it is changing very rapidly. This engineering is an economic drive for the nation. Many spectacular achievements have been made in the last 50 years, especially in the last 20 years. The country has achieved a great feats in the engineering arena. The country, through engineering profession, has created many wonders. They have created a great infrastructure, a modern society with a very high quality infrastructure, and it's industrial production, mechanized agriculture, modern transportation systems, and many things have been built. Many novel communication technologies have come into picture, and all this has happened because of the engineering profession. But in addition to that, the engineering profession, many novel, interdisciplinary, cross-disciplinary, and disruptive technologies also have emerged because of the better understanding of the science. These things have come in the form of nanotechnology, biomedical engineering, and sensors, robotics. So this is where now the engineering disciplines are merging now. It is no longer a single discipline. You as an engineer no longer call yourself, although you may have a qualified in a particular discipline like a mechanical, electrical, civil and all, but doesn't prevent you from getting to know what is happening in other disciplines, because if they have to create a bigger impact, create a solution to the societal problems, make a much larger, what you call productivity, improve efficiency, bringing new processes, new algorithms, understanding of the human system. This needs an interdisciplinary approach where you not only learn something about the other engineering, also need to work with the experts in other discipline. Only when you do this one, you will be able to create a solution to that kind of a problem. The problems that arises for our society are more complex. It is no longer a single domain application, single domain solutions. It is a multi-domain solutions for which you need to pick up, because basically you should know what other disciplines, solutions, understanding requires that particular problem. Once you know, you can bring those people around you and pool your resources and see you start working on, and we can do that one. So these are the challenges for you. Challenges of not only applying your challenges of learning, bringing together the other disciplines, understanding the complex problems, and you apply this one. As I mentioned to you, engineering is no longer a single discipline. It is the nature of engineering is changing very rapidly. You have seen that one. Now, not only the boundaries between the various engineering disciplines is disappearing, boundaries between the various other disciplines, humanities. You know, now I was just there last week in Zurich and Lausanne and Geneva. You know, they have what you call the digital humanities. You know, you can imagine that present day context, the digitalization and the technological innovations are changing the life very significantly. You cannot, what perhaps last 20 years, you have seen many unimaginable things have happened, but next 10, 20 years, much more unimaginable things are going to happen. And if we have to achieve those things, understand those things, assimilate, embrace, and bring it to the society, you need to learn all those things. And this is system engineering. It is no longer a thing, and you need to be very enthusiastic and motivated and passionate and curious to know all these things and contribute and learn these things and apply these things. And in addition to that, the two other things that are important in engineering is a design, creativity in design. You know, design is there everywhere. It is not only the buildings and machines and all, even a design of a product, you know, design of a machine system, you know, human brain or technology interfaces. All these things are coming, you know, I don't have to tell you the kind of a disciplines that have emerged, whether it's artificial intelligence, big data, data analytics, robotics, machine learning, you know, and sensors. You know, all these things you need to know a little bit, and you must be excited about it, motivated about it, and that when you do that one, you'll be able to play a much higher role in your profession, not only to your professional responsibility, and also look at your society around you. You know, one thing that is important in our country is still, although the digitalization has taken place, people using the mobile phone, but the effectiveness and the utilization of these things has not happened in the rural areas, and especially in small towns, small villages. They own these mobile phones, but they're not able to use it effectively other than talking. This is where your expertise will come. How do you do it in a local language? How do you teach the simple human being, people around, you know, in the villages and towns, small towns, who are not able to use the smartphone to the extent that all of us use or many of us use, how we make it simplify them? So they also should be able to do the transactions, acquire the benefits of this, all these modern technologies by some kind of a simplicity, and that they are able to access it, use it, understand it, apply it. For all these things, you need to work. You need to work where you have come from that kind of a background and take back your technology to those people. So that is another thing that you should do. And you also understand what country is facing the problems. You know, with all these technologies that you have learned, all the high quality of the life that you are enjoying, but there are other issues concerned with that one, with a growing population, decreasing resources. You need to sort out the growing demands of energy, water, housing, clean air, clean environment, sustainability. All these things, one way the technology has given you some of these things, but again, you need to use these technologies to solve those formidable challenges or the grand challenges of the society and the engineering if the future generation has to live a sustainable life. It means what you have enjoyed should be also made available to the future generation, you know, without destroying our nature, our natural resources. So for which you have to apply totally a second level or another level of disruptive technologies, where at a micro level, at a nano level, see the people's requirements for energy, water are met by your imaginative solutions, your imaginative research. So I mentioned to you, you need to reach out to other people. In addition, you also need to work with the society, stakeholders. You know, only when you understand their problems, then only you will be able to come out solutions and see this engineering solutions that you create is also acceptable to them. You cannot do it in isolation and impose on them. You must see, talk to the society as a stakeholders and the people around you and build acceptable technology for them without causing a disruption of the environment and without causing any disruptions on any other things. So you need to do those things. And I don't have to tell you the emergence of all these novel and disruptive technologies and nanotechnologies, sensors, which you have been using in your various projects, okay, whether building a circuit, building a biomedical engineering, imaging process. So you need to be aware of all these things. The other thing that I would like to talk to you about it is the life. You know, life, what is the success in life? Success in life, not merely obtaining a very high position, getting a very high salary, and, you know, living a very opulent life. You know, it is a life that you have to live where others should appreciate the way in which you conduct in society, not only in a professional body in your profession, but outside your profession. And this requires, you know, upholding the values and ethics in whatever you think that you do. That is what somehow, young engineers, you are all talented, brilliant, I'm sure you'll be doing it, but if you look back, why our country is not that developed? Why still we have plagued with a lot of other issues? Okay, whether the infant mortality, the trust level in the society, and the ability to adhere to the rules, and the most common man getting his due from the society without any much of the intervention of various kind, that has to be, is not there in our country at the moment. That is only one of the few things that distinguishes the developing nation from the developed nations. Okay, the things which work automatically, people follow process and procedures, that this is not happening in our country. And you youngsters, with all the affiliate of whatever aspirations and high quality life and all the salaries that you know you enjoy, but you must now stand up and may ensure that you uphold the values and ethics in your profession, not only in the office, but also outside, and make sure that you make a difference to the society, but the way in which you conduct, way in which you behave, and way in which you discharge your duties. So this is another important, I always want to stress, which is our generation perhaps needs to be told and retold again and again. Unless we adhere to these processes, our country may make all the kinds of achievements, but you will not be able to reach the last mile or the last man also to enjoy the benefits and society live peacefully and contentedly. And this can only happen if you have a trustworthy society and where every action is being scrutinized by people around you, and you have to conduct yourself in such a way that you live in a very exemplary way. The other thing is that I want to talk to you about is, you know, you always in your life at some different stages, you look for various role models or people who gave up their personal wealth, worked very dedicatedly, struggled hard to give something back to the society. It could be right from the Independence Day, it could be Mahatma Gandhi, it could be many, many people like that in every arena. Our own people, Swami Vivekananda, you know, the Thomas Alva Edison, and many very big people, you know, personalities as a Homi Baba. So you must also look for such people in your life where you can pick up something and contribute, and this can continue with the people around you who contributed in building this kind of institutions. How much they have struggled to not have to build the institutions, and where you are graduated and able to provide, you know, live much more happily than what they did it. So please, you know, you must keep this kind of a role models in your mind all the time when you do get up in the morning, how you conduct your things in your profession as a technologist and as a human being. So what is important is, in addition to your technological skill, technological excellence, the human values, human qualities, human excellence, that is equally important if society has to survive for a longer time without much of difficulty, without much of discontent, much of the violence, much of the unhappiness. So this is important. I'm sure that you will be able to do, your generation, learn all these things. And what I would like to finally, what I'd like to say is, it is not the, I always quote this, this particular sentence because I like this thing when I listen to the lot of people, you know, it is not the longevity of the life, how long you live, okay, how well you live, but how consciously you are intensified in your in your day-to-day activities, in your life, people around you, how very you are conscious of how intensively you live lead a conscious life, life full of consciousness. So that is more important, and I am sure we will be doing this one and help build a greater nation, a nation of a very happy people, contented people, and through our future generation can also live a life, kind of life that we have led and do that one. So with these remarks, I thank you once again. I wish all of you very great in the years to come. Best of luck.
Be now presented.
And Sobana Biomedical, 7th rank. And Karunya CSE, 8th rank. And Vijayalakshmi, 11th rank. Kemalada ME CSE, 15th rank. Sushanti, ME CSE, 21 rank. Soundarya, Biomedical, 27th rank. Supasri, BE Triple, 27th rank. Farhana Begum, BME, 29th rank. Pavitra, 31st rank. Sangeeta, BTEC IT, 31st rank. Prem Kumar, Mechanical, 32nd. Radhika, Biomedical, 33rd. Arunodaya, MECSE, 33rd. Nasreen Banu, 34th. Vivek, 36th rank, BME. Reshma, IT, 37th rank. Kannan, ECE, 40th rank. Bhuja M. Naidu, CSE, 41st rank. Jinu Mariam, Triple E, 44th rank. Sandhya, BTEC IT, 45th rank. Bharati, CSE, MECSE, 45th rank. Muthupriya, BECSE, 46th rank. Charles, BE Triple E, 46th. Josna, BECSE, 47th. Sukandi, BTEC IT, 47th. Finally, the department topper, the civil department, Ruba. the Department of Biomedical Engineering, Boys, Ashwin Kumar, Biomedical Boys Ashwin Kumar, Bharat, Lokesh Kumar, Matthews, Paramesh, Satish, Satya Narayanan, Srinivasan, Venkateshan, Vijay, Yasir Ahmed. Then biomedical girls, Abhinaya, Abhirami, Aishwarya, Anuradha, Tipa, Divya, Gayatri, Hemalata, Kaliyammal, Kanmani, Kavya, Kirtana, Lata, Manimala, Manisha, Prapacha, Rajalakshmi, Ramya, Sandhya, Sangamitra, Sanmugapriya, Saundarya, Suchita, Susmita, Tamilarasi, and Vaishnavi. Civil Engineering Boys, Aditya, Arun, Balaji, Dinesh, Ilangovan, Kopinathan, Gautaman, Jagadish Babu, Jagadishwar, Manoj Kumar, Veera Pandi, Mohammed Madina, Narendra, Nirmal Kumar, Pandi Durai, Prem Sai, Praveen Kumar, Rafiq Ahmed Sharif, Rahul Ram, Rajeswaran, Santosh, Tirukumaran, Valliyappan, Viknesh, Viknesh R, Yeswant, Dinesh Kumar, Govardhan, Narendran, Narendran DS, ప్రసన్న, రాహుల్, సబ్రాస్ ఖాన్, విఘ్నేష్. దెన్ గర్ల్స్ అనుసూయ, ధనలక్ష్మి, కీర్తన, మహాదేవి, మోనిష, పార్కవి, రమ్య, సహాయ రేష్మ, సస్తిక, సీతాలక్ష్మి, షణ్ముఖప్రియ, స్నేహ, సుగాసిని, విష్ణుప్రియ. దెన్ కంప్యూటర్ సైన్స్ అండ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ బాయ్స్ ఆకాష్, అరవింద్, అశ్విన్ కుమార్, బాలమణిగండన్, దినేశ్వరన్, ఎలిలరసన్, గోవిందరాజ్, ఈశ్వర్ ప్రసాద్, కిషాన్, కుల్దీప్, మకేష్, మొహమ్మద్ సదకుతుల్లా, నందకుమార్, నవీన్ నాయుడు, రామ్ కుమార్, సంతోష్, సత్య సుకందన్, సెల్వ గణేష్, సింసన్, శ్రీనివాస్, సుబ్రహ్మణ్యన్, తనిహేవేడ్, విజయ్, యోకేష్ అండ్ యువరాజ్. CSE girls, Amala, Amirta, Anita, Anupriya, Ashwini, Aswita, Bhavani, Charuha, Chitra, Deepika, Deepika yes, Divya, గణప్రియ, కౌసల్య, జయపార్వతి, జయంతి, కవి, కీర్తన, లావణ్య, లోకేశ్వరి, మహాలక్ష్మి, మాలిని, మంజు, మీనాక్షి, మోనిష, ముత్తుసెల్వి, మైథిలి, నాన్సీ, నిర్మల మేరీ, నిషా, నిత్యలక్ష్మి, నివేత, పవిత్ర, పవిత్ర టీ, పూజ, పొర్కొడి, ప్రత్యూష, ప్రియదర్శిని, ప్రియదర్శిని వి, రమ్య, రేణుగాదేవి, రేష్మ, సాయిప్రియ, షణ్ముఖప్రియ, షణ్ముఖప్రియ ఎస్, షర్మిల, షణ్ముఖ సుందరి, సౌందర్య ఆర్, సౌందర్య సౌమ్య ఎస్ఆర్, సౌమ్య ఎస్, సుహాసిని, శ్వేత, శ్వేత ఎస్, ధనుజ, వినిత, జిఆర్ నందిని, వినోదిని. ఎలక్ట్రానిక్స్ అండ్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ బాయ్స్ Vice ECE Vice Ajit Kumar, Arvind Kumar, Arul Murugan, Arun, Arun Kumar, Arun Kumar S, Arun Rai, Bala Murugan, Bharat Kumar, Vigyan Limichan, Dinesh Kumar, Kondipalli Panis Kumar, Kautam, Kautam Prabhakar, Jagadish Babu, Kamalesh, Karan Krishidas, Karthik, Nagabalaji Reddy, Krishna Kumar, Agileshwar Reddy, Madan, Magesh Kumar, Magadi Krishna, Manoj Kumar, Mohammad Isan, Rafi, Murugan, Muthu Manikandan, Nitish, Prashant Kumar Reddy, Prem Kumar, Reddy Prasad, Rakesh, Rishabh, Rohit Yadav, Sairam Kumar, Saran Kumar, Sesant Kumar, Siva Balaji, Srinivasan, Srinivasan T, Syed Abdul Razak, Viknesh, Vinod Kumar, Vishal, Yeswant Kumar, Barkava. Girls Adeline Angel CSE as Aishwarya, Anita, Anita B, Arya, Ashwini, Ashwini B, Aspi, Pavatarini, Plessy Roda, Divya, Harini, Janagi, Kalaranjani, Kavya Lekha, Kirtana, Kiranmai, Kirithya, Kausalya, Lekha Shri, Atri Mahalashmi, Maladi, Manjula, Mariswari, Mayuri, Meena, Monika, Monisha, Mukhila, Nandini, Nitya, Niveda, Puchita, Prema, Priyanga, Priyanga P, Pugalarasi, Rahavi, Rajalakshmi, Rajapriya, Ramya E, Ramya R, Revati, Sandhya, Saranya, Satya Banu, Shaheen Fatima, Shriya, Sijimol, Sri Devi, Sri Priya, Sudar, Sveta, Dejaswini, Vijayalakshmi, Bimala and Yamuna. அங்க அப்படி இங்க நின்னுக்கங்க அப்படி ட்ரிபிளி பாய்ஸ் Tribly Boys Ahmed Rasuldeen, Aravind, Arjun, Srinivasa Rupesh Kumar, Balaji, Vinod Kumar Reddy, Kaudaman, Kopal Patel, Gauri Shankar, Kautam S, Guru Murthy, Hari Prakash, Jay Kumar, Karmuhil, Karthik, Gavaskar, Kaviyarasu, Manihandan, Manoj Kumar, Mohideen Abdul Qadir, Mukesh Kumar, Nikhil Kumar Singh, Niranjan, Palaniyappan, Praveen Kumar, Ranjit Kumar, Sabari Rajan, Sai Ravikiran, Sakti Vel, Swaminathan, Santosh Kumar, Sarath Kumar, Saravanan, Satyanathan, Sarat Chandran Nair, Shyam Sundar, Sivanesh, Sivaranjan, Sudhakar Raj, Suresh, Swapnil Nikar, Tamil Maran, Tyagarajan, Sivarami Reddy, Vishnu Kumar Reddy, Vetri Vel, Vinay Kumar, George Newton, Hari Krishnan, Joshua Nesakumar, Karthik, Sari Madurai, Madhuri, Sheikh Abdullah. So girls, Tribly girls Abhinaya, Arulmani, Indumadi, Aishwarya, Komadi, Mageshwari, Meenakshi, Muttu Meenakshi, Maithili, Nitya, Niveta, Padmapriya, Praveena Kumari, Brithi Monika, Sandhya, Sharmila, Sindhu, Sri Udaya Lakshmi, Subhasini, Subhasri, Supriya, Tamil Chelvi, Tamarai Chelvi, Vanaja, and Vasuprada. Mechanical Engineering Boys Achil Tino, Shyam Prakash, Anish, Anthony Deva, Aravind, Arkad Ganesh Kirish, Arjun N, Arjun S, Arun B, Arun M, Arun Kumar P, Ashok Kumar J, Aswin Anto J. Ayyappan, Bachrul Rahman, Pala Kumaran, Bala Murugan V, Venkata Rajesh Reddy, Daniel Charles, Deepak, Dheeraj, Dinesh, Dinesh Kumar, Dinesh Shankar, Dinesh Verma, Divagar, Gaddam Madhu, Kovatan Chowdhury, Kautam, Hari Kumaran, Hari Prasad, Hari Shankar, Jagannath, Hemanadan, Jay Kishore, Kabilan, Karthik Sai, Karthikeyan R, Karthikeyan S, Karunakaran, Kesavan, Kishore, Kausik, Lokesh, Venkata Ramana Kaurav, Mohammed Hamdan, Mohana Sundaram, Muthiswaran, Muttu, Musamil Akhtar, Nandakumar, Naveen Subramanian, Nikhil, Venkat Vinith, Param Kirti, Kiran Kumar, Pradeep, Prakash, Prasant, Praveen, Prithiviraj, Rahul, Rajarajan, Ramasami, Ram Prasad, Ranjit, Revanth Jay Kumar, Sai Sri Harish, Samiullah, Santosh Kumar, Saravana Kumar, Saravanan, Sasidharan, Satkurunadan, Satish Kumar, Siddharth Kausik, Sivachandran, Sivanesh, Sivaranjit, Subramanian, Sudesh, Tarun, Tata Prabhu, Uchal, Varun Raj, Vasudevan, Venkateshan, Venkatesh, Viknesh, Viknesh V, Vikneshwar, Vikneshwaran, Vijay Kumar, Ajit Kumar, Balaji Parath Kumar, Kogulnath, Jayadeep, Jeeva, Mani Paradi, Naveen Kumar, Nitin, Prabhu, Prateep, Satish Kumar, Sundar, and Venkatesh. Information technology boys, Appas, Ajit Kumar, Ajit Prabhakar, Aslam, Balachandar, Balasupramanian, Desigan, Ganesh, Ganesh JP, Karthik, Karthik K, Kamalakannan, Manigandan, Manoj Kumar, Mohammed Asaruddin, Prasant, Praveen Kumar, Praveen, Prem Kumar L, Ramanadan, Ram Kumar, Rupesh, Shriram, Shyam Sundar, Sridhar Rajan, Sundaravel, Venkatesh, Vijay, Vishal, Yuvaraj, Dilip Kumar. IT girls, Abhinaya, Aishwarya, Bhavya Devi, Bhuvaneshwari, Carolyn Jennifer, Deepasri, Divya, Gayatri, Induja, Kartika, Kirtika, Lavanya, Lokeshwari, Maheshwari, Manjula, Manjula P, Meena, Nandini Devi, Nasreen Baisha, Navanita, Niveda, Bhavitra Devi, Pechi Ammal, Pooja, Priyadarshini, Priyadarshini M, Priyanka, Puvana, Radhika, Ramya, Rohini, Sandhya, Saranya, Selvarani, Sinduja, Shruti, Suchita, Sunita, Suryavarsini, Susmita, Sveta, Uma, Vanmadi, Vaishali Sharmila, Ivarani. MECSE, Plessy Janila, Nandini, then ME Networking, Ignatius Payos, Anita, ME Embedded System Technologies, Rajalakshmi, Ramya, Sophia, ME VLSI, Naharajan, Soundarya, 21. MTech IT, Gauri Manchu, Haripriya, Jayalakshmi. அதுக்கப்புறம் இதை சொல்லிட்டேன். BE Electronics and Communication Engineering, BE Electrical and Electronics Engineering, BE Mechanical Engineering, BTech Information Technology, ME Computer Science Technology, ME Network Engineering, ME VLSI Design and MTech Information Technology. Upon candidates who in the examination conducted by Anna University Chennai in 2017 to be duly qualified to receive the degrees.
Graduates, please stand up and stress repeat. We shall in thought, word and deed ever endeavor to be scrupulously honest in our profession and shall uphold the dignity and integrity of our profession and the honor of university. We shall uphold and advance social order and the well-being of our fellow, the unity, integrity and secular ideal of our country. I will read, you need not repeat. Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Sakuntala Engineering College, I admit you to the branches of BE Biomedical Engineering, BE Civil Engineering, BE Computer Science and Engineering, BE Electronic and Communication Engineering, BE Electrical and Electronic Engineering, BE Mechanical Engineering, BTech Information Technology, ME Computer Science and Engineering, ME Embedded Systems Technology, ME Network Engineering, ME VLSI Design and MTech Information Technology. And upon the candidates who in the examination conducted by Anna University Chennai in 2017 held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same, and in token thereof you have been presented with those degrees, and I authorize you to wear the robes obtained as insignia of your degree. The chairman and chief guest will sign the record of degrees. Over. I dissolve this convocation. National anthem, please.